Many questions never have an expiration date and are always asked of me. One of the most important is, can I work as a PLC programmer? This question is in the category of the most frequent asked question. Today, I want to answer it to see who can work as a PLC man and who should not choose PLC. Hello, I'm Ehsan. If you are coming here for the first time, you are very welcome. Be sure to subscribe because in the following video, I will answer how you can work as a PLC person. Is it right or should I say PLC man? I think PLC person is better. Anyway, thank you very much if you are already following us. Let's go to the video. To see if I can work with a PLC, we must first see what a PLC needs. After that, we can have an assessment of our abilities. In general, PLC and automation work with software and hardware. Let's look at what hardware is. In the hardware debate, you need to be familiar with the most essential issues, which is copper wire to more advanced equipment such as drive and electric motors. Why do I say familiar, not an expert? Because when we start, no one knows these, or these are not innate knowledge. I can even say a high percentage of graduates are not familiar with this equipment when they are finished college. Of course, because the university did not teach them, they are not to blame, but they are irresponsible because they never learn anything outside the university. Familiarity, what does it mean? When I say drive, Google what is drive and read a few paragraphs to understand what this device does. For example, the drive is mainly used to control the speed of the electric motor. Familiarity with the electric motors also means knowing the difference between single phase and three phase motors in general. But the truth is that the effective way to learn is not to learn everything like a workbook. It is right to act first and then learn as needed. In this way, you will never forget and learning costs will be saved. Fortunately, the hardware elements of automation, such as PLC itself, wires, relay, contactors, motors, drive, sensor, etc., are so general that anyone can learn about them. And remember, in general, the importance of hardware in automation at the best is 20%. So, where is the difference between an engineer and a certified engineer? The following discussion. Software. Now it's time to like now, so that we can go to the exciting discussion of the software. Why is software or programming in automation so important? Because creativity comes from it. This is where we can do whatever the employer or ourselves like. This is where modifying a pre-written program can save you a lot of money. The programming language using PLC are very diverse, but the one that we work on and is very pervasive in industry and also used for other industrial equipment is the ladder diagram. If you want to know more about PLC languages, watch this video. I reviewed all the programming languages and told you what is best. The ladder diagram is much simpler than C++, so it is considered as a functional language that can quickly be learned and worked. So if you have worked with the computer in your life or are familiar with it, you can learn it too. But in the end, it all depends on your passion. Guys, in short, there is so much money in this market, but in the end, success depends on your hard work. PLC training on the internet is endless. Good tutorials are everywhere. Try to use them all and get better in your business. I hope this video has a positive impact on your life. Your favorite section, the question. I do not have a question this time, but I have a request. If you know someone active in PLC and is famous in your country, write their name here. Or if they have a website or channel, give us the link here. Do not miss this video if you want to start PLC with free books. Here are great books for you. These books are not just for a specific brand, and you can use them for most PLCs. I love you so much and see you soon.